Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to change the background color or the page color in your Adobe Illustrator file. And I'm also going to show you how to add the same background page color to every page in your Illustrator file too. All right, let's get started. Okay, I've got the file open where I want to change the background color. I want to make this kind of a lighter blue. Now, Illustrator isn't like a lot of programs where you actually can set a background color. So all you have to do is just draw a rectangle back there. So I'm going to get on my rectangle tool. I'm going to drag from up here. I'm going to completely cover my artboard, plus a little bit, because you don't want to end up with a little white space there if you don't get it exactly right. So I always leave overhang like this. And then I'll double click on the fill color, and we have a color picker here where you can change the hue here, and then change how much gray or black is in it. Now I already have a color I picked out, so I want it to be this hex code, and I'll say okay. Okay, so this bluish gray color is now in the front, and I want to send it to the back. So I'll hit Shift, Command, and left bracket. That's Shift, Control, and left bracket on a PC, or you can go to Object, Arrange, and Send to Back right here. Now, if you don't want to accidentally select this box, you can add it on another layer. So I'm going to hit F7 to do that, and that'll bring up my Layers panel. That's also under Window right here. I'm going to add a new layer. So it's on top now. I'm just going to click over here in this empty space and drag it underneath the layer that everything's on. And then with just that box selected, I'm going to click this little red box on this layer. The color of it doesn't really matter, so don't worry if it's a different color. And then just click and drag this down below. And it won't change, but now your box is on a lower level and you can lock it. And now if you get on your selection tool and just select things, you can move those around without accidentally clicking on this background. I'll unlock that for now. I'm going to just delete this stuff over to the side, and I'm going to make a lot of different artboards, and I want to apply this same blue color to all of these other artboards. Now you could click and drag like this, but I wouldn't do it that way. It can cause some problems if you're exporting to different file types. Instead of doing it that way, I want to put this same box as a background for each of these. So I'll select my box. I'll make sure to click on this first artboard and select that. So your artboard needs to be selected and the box needs to be selected. I'll cut it with Command X or Control X, and then I'm going to come up here to Edit and paste on all artboards. So now you have all those artboards on the lower level and you can lock them, which means you can't select them anymore. And that's it. All right, I hope this video was helpful, and please let me know what you'd like to learn next. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.